This is the C.C.Jensen D10 Desorber Combi. This is a system for removing water from oil, in addition to offering fine filtration for a variety of oil systems.
The Desorber products operate on the ability of cold air to draw in moisture as it heats up. Hot oil in the Desorber chamber is met with cold air bubbles that enter from the bottom. As the bubbles rise through the oil, they heat up and expand, pulling in moisture from the surrounding oil. The hot, moist air is then cooled, either with air, water, or a refrigeration circuit, depending on the model. The cooling process condenses the water. Then the air enters the cyclone, where the water drops out of the air, allowing the dry air to then be recirculated back through the process. The water is drained off. The oil system has a supply pump, which runs continuously at fixed speed, and a discharge pump, which switches between high speed and low speed to maintain the correct oil level in the chamber. The lower level switch is used to vary the discharge pump between low and high speed, whereas the upper level switch trips an alarm as a safety feature.
Now I'm going to take you through the various components of the D10 Combi and talk about their function and how they work together. So for starters, we have the Desorber system is located on the bottom, and the filter portion is located up on the top. The two systems are integrated together through the plumbing, and the operation is managed by the same control panel. You can see that this particular Desorber is mounted on a cart for mobile use, has casters, heavy-duty handles at both ends, and hose hangers. You can get it with or without the cart base. So the main components of the Desorber system include the control panel, which operates both the Desorber and the filter. We have the filter system up here with the pump and the motor, pressure gauge, automatic air vent, isolation valves to keep the filter separate from the Desorber if you only wish to use one or the other. Around the back, you'll find the Desorber chamber with the heater inside. We have the inlet pump, the cooling unit, and the air blower. Now I'm going to walk you through the oil flow path as it travels through the unit. So the oil starts by traveling in at the inlet. Right at the inlet valve, there's a T, which is the suction line going to the filter up on top. Following the T is a solenoid valve. This will isolate the Desorber from the rest of your oil system. In case there's an increase of pressure in the main system, this will close while the Desorber is not operating to prevent it from the chance of overfilling. Following the solenoid valve, we have the suction pump. This is pumping oil from your system into the Desorber chamber. Inside the Desorber chamber is an electric heater that will heat the oil as it's in the chamber. From the chamber, the oil will flow out through the bottom and into the discharge pump. Following the discharge pump, the oil will return to the system, or depending on the level in the chamber, may return back to the chamber to keep that level in check. At the back of the chamber is the bypass valve. This will open and close in order to keep the proper level of oil in the Desorber chamber. Following the T here, there's a check valve to prevent any backflow. And after the check valve is another T. This is the return from the filter unit, and from there travels back to your oil system. Mounted up top here is the air blower. So this will pump the air into the Desorber chamber, down through the center, and the pipe on the inside of the chamber brings the air down to the bottom, where a diffuser spreads it out and creates those tiny bubbles, the air that will bubble up through the oil. Once it comes to the top and it's absorbed the moisture from the oil, the air is taken off and comes down into the chilling unit. From here, the air is cooled. As the air is cooled, the water will condense and will collect at the bottom of this chamber and be discharged through this hose. So always make sure you have the hose down below the level of the cooler in order to drain the water out. We like to catch the water in a pail so you can see how much water you've collected from the Desorber. The filter unit is a basic HDU2727. So the oil pump here is drawing the oil in. We have these, again, these ball valves here in order to isolate it from the system. So if you're going to do a filter change on the unit, you'll want to close these. Here's the drain. This will allow you to drain the housing out, and the filter change is conducted as a normal HDU2727. Up here we have our pressure gauge, and on this side is the automatic air vent. So this will bleed out the air automatically when you start the unit up. Over here we have our pre-filter sample point, where you can collect oil samples. And this unit also includes a pressure switch at the back here that will alert on the control panel if you exceed the filter change pressure of the unit. On the control panel, we have the main operator interface here. We have an emergency stop, which you can turn to reset. And we have the fault button, or the fault light, which you can press to clear faults. On the control panel, we have the operator interface, the fault light and reset, the emergency stop. Now we'll have a look inside the panel to show you the main components. From the top to bottom, we have the Siemens smart relay. We have all of our branch circuit fuses for the various loads. We have our power supply for the low voltage circuits. Here we have our main contactor and auxiliary contactors. We have a set of relays. We have the thermistor sensors for the motors. We have a temperature controller. Here's the main disconnect switch, which is operated from the left side of the control panel. Our terminal blocks down here, and additional contactors for the various loads. Now I'm going to power up the unit and show you how it operates. After a moment, you'll see the screen boot up. It's now telling me to press the common alarm reset button. That will clear it. And now we're at the main interface, which will allow you to start and stop the desorber and the filter. So the F1 button corresponds to start desorber, and the F2 is the start of the filter, and pressing them again will stop accordingly. So I'll go ahead and press the start for the desorber. So you hear the systems turn on. Now you can see that pressing F1 again is going to stop it. And there it goes. Likewise with the filter, we can start the filter pump and press it again to stop. At any time, you can press the emergency stop, and this will halt everything immediately, the desorber and the filter. In order to clear the emergency stop, you need to reset the button by turning it. It will pop out. And then you need to acknowledge the fault on the display by pressing the enter key. Now it tells us to press the common alarm reset again to begin, and now we're ready to operate. This unit also has a number of faults built into it that will alert you if there's a problem, such as a level problem with the desorber chamber, a high pressure fault on the filter unit, or a spill sensor, which is in the pan. By activating one of the faults, the red light will come on, it will halt the unit, and display a message on the screen as to what's happened. So you need to acknowledge the fault before you can begin again. So that's the overview of the D10 Desorber Combi system. For any additional questions or for more information, feel free to contact us at the links below.